The source of those controversial Election Day robocalls has tonight been revealed. Our big story tonight, a paid political consultant to the Bob Ehrlich campaign is taking responsibility for the controversial calls.
11 News reporter, I-Team reporter David Collins is following developments and joins us now live from the newsroom with more on that story. David?
Marianne, subpoenas from the state prosecutor's office has already reached the Pennsylvania firm where the robocalls originated. Baltimore-based political operative Julius Henson says he expects to get one too. He's a paid consultant with the Ehrlich campaign, and tonight he's taking responsibility for the call, but he also firmly believes he didn't break the law.
I'm on the Bob Ehrlich team. We thought that a call like that would help, and we made the call.
Did Mr. Ehrlich know about the actual message?
Mr. Ehrlich had probably no knowledge of the call.
Julius Henson is a longtime political operative based in Baltimore. He runs two consulting firms. He says the robocall was designed to energize Ehrlich voters, not suppress turnout.
The call was made for voters in Baltimore City who was not going to go to the polls and vote. It was counterintuitive, okay? We never said in that call, which I didn't make, it never said don't vote. It never told anybody to stay home. It didn't do that. And on the contrary, the call was designed to have people who would have gone to vote for Bob Ehrlich go out and vote for him.
We'll speak now. No edicts, though.
State Board of Elections filings indicate Bob Ehrlich paid Henson more than $97,000 in political consulting fees. A campaign spokesman said no comment. Rhonda Russell works for Henson's Universal Elections Company. On election night, Russell voiced a robocall to residents in Baltimore City and Prince George's County.
I'm calling to let everyone know that Governor O'Malley and President Obama have been successful. Our goals have been met. The polls were correct, and we took it safe. We're okay. Relax. Everything is fine. The only thing left is to watch it on TV tonight.
The robocall came from robodial.org, a Pennsylvania company. Owner Mark Hampton says these types of calls are not tolerated. In an email, Hampton writes, she used her credit card to make the purchase, recorded the call herself, uploaded the phone list to our system, and ran the call. The system is fully automated, so she was able to do this without our knowledge. The call was universally condemned. U.S. Senator Ben Cardin asked the U.S. Attorney General to investigate Voting Rights Act violations.
Well, I want the people who are responsible to be held accountable so that in the future, everyone's on notice. If you do this, it's against the law and you're going to be held responsible.
On election night, State Attorney General Doug Gansler said his office is investigating the call as an act of voter suppression. He's now evaluating how this latest information will impact that probe. Henson has a reputation for political shenanigans. He disrupted a key endorsement for O'Malley the first time he ran for mayor. He dug into the personal life of Warren Brown, which caused him to withdraw from a city state's attorney's race. He was behind the effort depicting Republican candidate for governor Ellen Sauerbrey as an enemy of civil rights. As far as the robocall is concerned, Henson says he does not believe he broke the law.
I'm lost for what the big deal about the call is.
So far, the only people coming forward who got the calls have been Democrats. The state records reveal that a number of elected officials have hired Henson over the years. City Council President Jack Young paid Henson $23,000. The council president says he has now severed ties with Mr. Henson. State Senator Nathaniel McFadden says, quote, in the future, the 45th District Unity Team will be more careful with our regard to our campaign. Reporting live from the newsroom, David Collins, WBAL-TV 11 News.